Hey guys, welcome back to another Kickstarter unboxing and review video. Today we're going to take a look at some nearly forgotten tech. Some people collect them, some don't even know that they exist. We're talking about Nixie Tubes. The Ukrainian company Millclock now tries to bring them into the new century in form of a clock. So let's take a look if they succeeded. The Millclock ZIN18 Kickstarter campaign launched on February the 7th and successfully reached their goal with the help of just over 100 backers mid-March. So we actually got this package already a few weeks ago. The Kickstarter campaign was, well, it was really fast, and the delivery of the clocks was, compared to all the other delayed Kickstarter campaigns, it was pretty much on time. They modernized the look of the tubes and they are eager to take up mass production for Nixie lamps again, after their production was discontinued almost 50 years ago. Originally, Nixie tubes were invented by two Hungarian brothers in the early 1930s. They were called NIX1 tubes, which stands for Numerical Indicator Experimental Number 1. What the f*** is that name? Between the 30s and the 70s, they came up with a lot of variations for such tubes, until LED displays took over their place and they were no longer produced. So let's take a look inside of this box. So, let's open this box up and see what's inside. Some sort of envelope with, well, a cloth inside. Inside here, I think this is the power supply. And some more packaging, and something is wrapped inside there. So let's take this out. And that seems to be the separator for the numbers. Already looking pretty good. Here we have the PCB with the ports for the four Nixie tubes in order to form a clock, with the settings menu and the arrow keys to navigate through the menu. Up here we have the port for the power supply. And this seems to be the box that houses the Nixie tubes themselves. Looks really, really good. Let's open that up. Wow, they look gorgeous. Never seen new Nixie tubes before. You can already see the numbers shining up there, which are the anodes. And here you can see the cathode cage, aluminium body. And you can see the ports for the PCB. Okay, so let's put this thing together now and see what it looks like. So how do they actually work? The Nixie tube is a cold cathode display that takes advantage of glow discharge. The Nixie tube is filled with low-pressured neon gas. The glass tube contains a wire mesh anode which surrounds multiple cathodes shaped like numerals that are lined up. If the voltage between the anode and the cathode surpasses a certain value, the gas surrounding the numerical thread will start to glow. The complicated assembly process of the base, which consists of 47 steps, and the manufacturing of the tube, which includes glass production in ovens with over 1000 degrees Celsius, promises a lifespan of up to 20 years or 200 hours uninterrupted 24/7 use. That reflects in the price as well. One Nixie tube costs around $100, but that's pretty much the regular price for bigger used ones as well. So you can get either 4 like we did in order to display hours and minutes, or 6 to display the seconds as well. So how can you actually configure the clock? There are 9 different modes in the settings. By pressing the round button on the left, you enter the settings mode. The indication light shows which layer of the settings you are at right now. The different layers can be found in the manual. For example, the first layer lets you configure the hours and minutes. By pressing through the different layers, you can set the date, time zone, turn on Wi-Fi, switch to 12-hour mode, and set alarm, among other things. The whole setup seems pretty complicated. This is why they also developed an Android and iOS app. If you activate the Wi-Fi in the settings menu, you are able to configure the clock so that it connects to your home Wi-Fi. After that, you are able to change all the settings via the application. Though while testing the app, we had some connectivity issues. Also, the menu is not as pretty as you might expect from some other applications that are around. And sometimes, some menu buttons didn't do what was expected, or didn't even do anything at all. So let's sum things up. The tubes are really well made and just look awesome, especially in low light conditions where they really, really shine. The app could be polished a little bit more and they should really work on their connectivity. But other than that, if you like steampunk and you are in the need of a new clock and you have the money lying around because a full enclosure with 6 tubes costs $1 million. Nah, it's just $1,200, but go get some. The link will be in the video description. Well, since ours doesn't have an enclosure yet, we might be doing one in a future video. So if you guys have any ideas what the enclosure should be made of, let's say wood or metal, leave a comment down below. If you like this video, hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Click the bell button in order to get notified about new videos, and we will see you guys next time.